Hello everyone, I hope you're well. As you can see today, we've got some pork steaks. Thick cut these are. Now we've had these quite a few times. Look, it's from a local butcher where we live, well, 6 miles away. But they're pretty good, and we think they're still not bad value at £2.71. I know they have gone up in price, but they're nice. So we're going to have those. Before I do that, I wanted to show you. What's that doing on there? We had some spare ribs the other week, didn't we? When we did the meal for Wendy's birthday. And I bought some more. I thought they were about £3 something. So I bought some today and I said to Wendy, wow, they look nice, ribs they do. We'll do a video about the ribs, that'll be nice. What I didn't realise, God, this one's £4.96. Mate, £5 for a few ribs. Let me put it down. I mean, you can see, look, there is a good amount there, isn't there, I suppose. I've been a bit greedy, really. I got a bit carried away. But hopefully, all being well, we'll make that into a video as well, because we just sort of said, oh yeah, we chucked all this in and we slow cooked them and they were lovely, which they were. And I thought, oh, let's do it properly. We'll put it down on a video. Anyway, that's a bit besides the point, isn't it? Let's get back on these steaks. But first of all, let me go and put those ribs back in the freezer because we're not using them right now. Right, that's got them back in the freezer. Right, we're going to have this pork. Now, as I say, these are nice and we have even cooked them with, well, very little seasoning. We found we enjoy these as they are. As I say, they were £2.71. So I think you'll admit they're not bad value at that, really. One thing I wanted to ask. Now, one of the subscribers, no, not one, a number of subscribers have said, use this Old Bay seasoning. And, you know, we've not seen it. And then we saw it, I think it was Lidl. It doesn't tell you, does it? Was it Aldi? I think this was Lidl. And we saw it for sale. And Wendy says, that's that stuff that they sell. Oh, right, so we got it. Now, we've used this a couple of times. And it is quite nice. Well, we think so. We've had it on, we had a bit of cheap steak. I know we did the meal for Wendy's birthday, but, mate, her birthday was on for a week or more. So we had two little bits of steak. They were only cheap, but we put a bit of this on and it was okay. And, should you use it with pork? Well, I'd say, why not? It shows seafood, chicken, meat. Well, pork is meat, isn't it? Let's get some of this on. But Wendy did say to me, don't put too much on. So, we've got to be careful, haven't we? I don't want to upset her, put loads on. If I can get this lid off, we'll be laughing. Here we go. I mean, it is a nice tin. I tell you what though, look, I could have picked a bigger spoon, couldn't I? That's our latte spoon. So what we thought is, we'll just put a bit of this on. Oh, I didn't pat it dry, Graham. That's what a bit of tissue were for. Oh, you clown. I'm forgetting already. That's because I wanted to show you those ribs, didn't I? Oh, that one. It's gone in all right, actually. That's okay. Let's get a bit of... I don't want too much, that's the thing. Because it's quite tasty anyway. I don't want to put too much on. As I say, I think that is actually going to be plenty. Well, let's turn that over. I mean, I'm dabbing these dry, but to be fair, they're not really wet. These are quite nice pieces of meat. As I say, we've had these quite a few times, and I've had a look, and I said to Wendy, I don't think we've done these on a video. So I've had a look, and I don't think we have. I mean, if you know we have, you better let me know, because I couldn't find anything. Right, now, let's get a little dab more on that corner there. sure we don't need it, but I don't want the tin man, as I say. Wendy's doing a few bits and bobs in the garden. She's got all the veg on, but this is my job. Right, I just wash my hands and I'll bring you back. Right, I brought you back, but just as a bit of interest, really, look. Wendy's got the veg on, look. Let me see if I can, I don't know whether I can show you. Carrots. Sorry, can you see? I'm not sure now. Where are we? Potatoes, look. They're straight out the garden, those potatoes. A few carrots. They're not out of the garden, not this year. There we go, look. And that's all bubbling away. Now, we said about doing the meat. Let's get you back in the picture. Right, I said to Wendy, I know what we're going to do. 200 me duck, 20 minutes will do, but I went and got the book out. Now, I'm going to have to find pork because I've lost it. Oh, there we go. Now this is, look, pork chops on the bone, look. 205, 16 to 18 minutes. And I said 200 to 20 minutes. So I think we'll go 205, eh? Let's go for it. And we'll see how we go, because I will want it to come to temperature. And the reason we think this book might be fairly accurate, look, it's the book that came with the cassore. So we've got to be happy with that, haven't we? Right. Let's get this meat in the cassore and get it on. I'll bring you back. Right, let's get this tray out. Get this meat in the tray. Oh, come on. In you go. Come on. Oh, I'm probably not in the shot there, am I? But there's the bits of meat in there. Right, let's get them in the cassore. Right, let's get this cassore plugged in and switched on. There we go. Switcher on. And we're going 205. 20 minutes, and don't worry, before the end I will be checking the temperature, and off we go, and then I'll bring you back when there's something to show you. Well, that meat's cooking for 20 minutes. I just thought I'd mention this. We went to see my aunt yesterday in the home. She's in her 90s. She's sharper now than I was in my 20s. And me and Wendy were walking towards the room like, and this lady's smiling at her. So she said, oh, hello, me duck, you all right? And she says to her, she says, you know, every week I see you, and says, she's got such a lovely smile, meaning Wendy. You know, and, fair enough. So the cousin gets me aunt, and we're talking to her, and I said, oh, that lady, she says, Wendy's got a lovely smile, ain't she? And she says, what we're up with? Ain't she got her glasses on? Oh, God, she's worse than me, honest. That's what you get in this family. Oh, dear.
Right, we've got 5 minutes left. So let's just check out. Oh, crikey, this is going to take some cleaning after this. Let's get that probe in that meat. Let's see what we've got. I think we're going to make it. No, not quite. Look, that's great. There you go. Now, that some people would be happy with that, but no, I'm going to leave it the other 5 minutes. I tell you what, that is hissing and bubbling like a madman. That's making a mess in there, look. We know it'll come clean, don't we? We know it will. I'll bring you back. Now, just to let you know, you can see there we're on 195. Now, I opened that, and it was, as I say, there was smoke coming out, and it was hissing and bubbling like a madman.
So I turned it down to 195 now, and it does seem to be cooking pretty well. So we'll give it the, well, we've got 4 minutes left now. We'll give it the rest of the time, check the temperature, but I think we're not going to be far off. That's my fault, look, sitting outside talking rubbish instead of keeping my eye on it. No, it looked great, didn't it? I'll bring you back. Right, the cassoulet is finished. You see them? I bet you can hear them. Ah, sizzling like mad. I'll get burnt here, you see. Let's get that probe in there. Now, I'm happy with that. I know people tell me it doesn't need to be that high. There's no need, but we're happy at that temperature. And I can see the juices coming out there. Oh, the same again. Fabulous. And it's not miles over. It is over temperature, but not crazily. I'd say that's about the right amount of time. I mean, they are decent sized pieces. So we'll get this dished up now. Wendy's dashing about here, look, getting stuff ready. We'll just let them rest a few minutes and then we'll dish them up and bring you back. Oh, that's just a bit of quick video. Look, just showing you our dinner ready to eat. I bet you want me to cut that in half, don't you, so you can see it. Yeah, I've got to get my knife. I'll get back to you. Oh, I brought you back because... Is that in focus? Oh dear, I'm hitting the window. I'm too close. As you can see, look, it's cooked perfectly. Yeah, I've got a bit of a shadow there. But I don't think I was ever in any doubt. Anyway, that's our dinner. And I'm going to eat that now. I can put my pork back on the plate properly, look. And get my dinner out. Well, I've brought you back, everybody, because, again, every picture tells a story. Look at that. It didn't take me long to polish that off. Wendy said to me, I need a dinner. Can't we have a dinner? She says... You know, I want some fresh fruit and veg and stuff like that. Yeah, of course we can. So what's happened? Well, we've been a bit busy the last couple of days and we've had one or two quicker meals. We've been busy baking, as you know, and all this lot. So we've got a bit more time today and we had to go shopping. So, as I say, we've got them chops and they were lovely, they were. And I will do them spare ribs at some point in the future. But we needed that dinner, and God, already. Is it just me? I feel so much better when I've had a proper... We class that as a proper dinner, and that, oh, lovely. It was lovely. And I tell you what, dinner time, we had lovely cobs, and I had an egg custard from them I made. That were lovely as well. Anyway, we're rabbiting on here, aren't we? Wendy did say to me, perhaps I should mention, because people have asked me, we do actually have... Super thanks if you want to support the channel. And it's called Buy Me a Coffee. But Wendy says, why don't you rename it, you know, for buying ingredients, which it is really. So anyway, I thought I'd better mention that. And also, this old bay, we're, yeah, that were nice on there. I mean, somebody will probably tell me you shouldn't put it on pork. I don't know, no idea. It was lovely. We had it, as I say, we had it on a piece of cheap steak and it was lovely. And where were this from, Wendy? Was it Aldi?
Lidl.
Lidl? Well, I tell you what, I've learned something on YouTube. You're going to love this, look. Now, I shall get a picture and I shall put it here with a price. Or maybe here. Or even here. Oh, it could be here. It might even be here. Oh, come on, you're just being silly again. Yeah, I will. I'll find a picture out and put it on here. Right, now this time I'm going to leave you in peace, but we enjoyed that meal. God, I feel so much better already. It was marvellous. Right, look after yourselves. Bye. Well, I'm very sorry, everybody. I've had to bring you back again. Now, I might be able to edit this, but I don't know whether I can or I can't. So let's see what happens. But I'm mistaken. As Wendy pointed out to me, at the bottom of here... If that's one of our videos, there's a thanks. I hope you can see that. It says thanks down there. And if you press that, it allows you to give, I don't know how to term it. It's to say thanks for making the videos. Other people have it. Now, I thought this was the same as buy me a coffee, but it seems it's not because, oh dear, I'm out of my depth again. Buy me a coffee is, where is it? Oh no, I put it in every time. Oh God, mate, I'm dying of my tenor. Here, look, there's a link there to buy me a coffee. And if you press that link and open it, oh, if I can get it right.
That one.
Right. This takes you to the page here. And on this page, you can buy a coffee. And I know people have actually done it and they bought us a coffee. And we use it for like ingredients and things, you know. I hope I've explained that a bit better. I'll be honest, I thought it was the same thing. It's unbelievable, really, because I'm the one who puts it on, not Wendy. And Wendy says, you've got that wrong, have I? Oh dear, I do apologise. Anyway, I hope that makes some sense. So look after yourselves and we will see you soon. If you've enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. We'll see you in the next one. Bye.